set up a standardized system like we used to have at the shop for this, but I think I recall that level 4 was our stock or our material. That being said, Ned, I got a little ahead of myself. I'm going to go to planes. I'm going to select the DZ. This is a diameter and Z axis on our left, on our right, left to right. Is with the mill, you can draw in the stock, and then you can select the corners to define the stock. You can do that also with the lathe. The lathe's a little easier in a way because it's just a cylindrical piece. Why? You can just come into here, stock setup. It's on the left spindle. Some machines have a right-hand spindle or a sub-spindle. Go to properties. And then I can define it right here. I can look at my part and say it's 1.3 is a finish diameter. So it might be, a 1.5 diameter. And it's 3.5. So we'll call it 4 inches in length. And we can see here that the Z0 is going to be the tip of the part. At that point, so I'll just leave it there and click OK. Click OK. And we have a little, here's our dotted line. Laid this out on the other, this one here, you can see I laid this out with the open end to the right. We'll lay it out like this, but if you want to actually machine it, say for example, we make a spud, like an expandable spud or something, for the part to slip onto, and then we'll be machining it in this orientation. It's pretty easily just to redefine your planes and repost out the program at that point. If somebody's going to do that, we can always go back to that. I laid it out in this orientation here, thinking that if I was hanging on to the back end of the part, the engraving is the least amount of pressure compared to knurling. Knurling could be a lot of pressure on there, especially if it's a bump knurler. If it's a pinch knurler, it's not that bad. But I went ahead and set up in this way too, and this also allows it for us to cut the inside and everything else essentially almost complete except for the back side of it, which again we would have to flip it around and figure out how we're going to hang on to it. So I'm just going to lay it out like I did here. Go to levels. I'll say level 1 is my part wire. And remember, you might have encountered the tools being oriented different to your part than you intended to, because things are flipping around. We're not making any tool paths right now, so it's not as critical. But if we're making a tool path, make a little sequence. Choose your level, double check your plane, and then go to make your tool path, just to make sure your orientation is proper for what you're building. I'm going to leave it on the level here, and I'm going to create the interior of it. rectangle, and...
Can you drop the screen down a little? Or is it stuck up? It's not that big a deal, I just...
No, you guys can see it. Bad for a quick fix, huh? Okay. Yeah, it always kind of bugged me too, I just never... Thanks for running. Thanks for touching it. Okay, so let's make the interior here. What do we got? Looks like 9.65, so I'm going to create a height of 0.965. And my width is going to be, my finish length, 3.58. I'm going to let MasterCam do some math for me. The end of the part is 300, so
the width is with the height.
Oh, thanks. I'm having a Monday on Friday. Start out pretty good, but I just feel a little out of step. There we go. 3.58 - 0.3. So the old instructor, anytime there was a goof up like on prints or a project or something, it was typically, you know, a student made, and he'd go, well, you know, all the work's done by students. That wasn't too funny, sorry.
Enter.
It's me making the goof up. You catch me, keep me honest, huh? Click on anchor to center. For simplicity, and I'll just drop it right there. Click the green check, and it gets the part I want to transform, translate. Hold the shift key down, select everybody, end selection, move, reselect, right here, right here.
Mother. Yeah. Damn, that went quick.
Alright, so that's the interior, that's the easy part. That's the interior.
You mean click anchor to center?
I just do anchor to center. Morning, sir.
Morning.
I just do anchor to center because it's easy. I'm going to have to translate it either way. If I was to create a rectangle, say I just create a rectangle without anchor to center, and I click here, see, it shows up like this. And then I have to translate it in the, essentially, the Y and the X direction. And if I anchor it to center like I did that first rectangle, then I only have to translate it in the X direction. Back end of the part is 300 long, so I'm just going to translate this line, and I'm going to copy it in the Z minus 0.3. And this is going to establish the back end of my part. The hole is 260. We zoom in on this a little bit. You can go wireframe line. I could draw a line like this. Done. Can't really see it at the moment, but if I go transform, translate, where'd it go? That line? pin selection. If I say move, point 260, let's see if this is going to work out. Both sides. There's my hole. Now to double check it, because Lay's being a little goofy on the X, I'm going to go to analyze distance and put from here to here. And that's looking at the just the 2D dimension, 260. If we're looking at the D, remember D, the change in diameter, we're going to want to take a measurement from the center, see, from the center to that hole. That's our 260. So those lines are in the proper spot. This is a hole, so let's break these lines up. So if I go to wireframe, divide. This is a handy little tool, divide. And I can hover over the part you're going to click on, and the part that's going to disappear becomes the dash, the hidden line. See that? Now it looks like it has a little spot face, 500 diameter. So to figure out where that's at, one way might be to, I'm going to draw a line, I'm going to anchor to the middle here somewhere. There we go. I'm just going to draw a straight line down the middle. And then I'm going to translate it. Instead of the 260, I'm going to go 500 this time. And both directions. Now what that does is this sets that little flat spot face. And from this spot face, we have it angled coming out. What's it say? 7 degrees. So we could go to wireframe, line. Let's try this. If I click on here, if I go straight up, it's 90 degrees. So we want to come 7 degrees off of that. So let's try 90 minus 7. We could do that down below, or we could transform and what about mirror this line, copy, and it's already set up on the z-axis, so it shows you down here where it's going to be. If you like it, click on OK. Now we'll clean this up a little bit. We don't need these here. And it's a wireframe trim. This one to here. This one to here. out pretty good, drawing a line and then moving it for the diameter. We're doing that, or we could draw a rectangle. What do you guys want to do? You like drawing the line down the center and moving it out to the diameter, or we've been doing rectangles a lot in the past to establish our diameter. References?
The line in the middle is fine.
Create a line down the middle and translate it. Diameter is going to be 1.3. I want both directions. Okay. And from the end, it's 1.62. So if I go to translate, I'll take this line, end selection, I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to go to the right, so that's positive, so I'm going to go 1.62. Now the neat thing about trimming, we could just go trim this line to this line. See, it trims it right like that. We'll just go ahead and finish it up. Bring it up a little bit. Okay, then I'm going to go to divide, get rid of the middle section here. I'm going to have a little tiny step up here at the top. And that's why I left these little straight lines there. Click the OK button. I'm going to break for a moment here and select Save As. Desktop. Save my work. And let's see. The rest of the body is where'd it go? 1.265. So want to go another line down the middle. Transform, translate, move. Diameter is 1.265. Both directions. Click OK. And now I'll zoom in here so you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to go to wireframe trim. Turn this one to here. Now here's where you got to be a little careful. You want to click on the part you want to keep. If you click over here, oops, that's not what you want. So when you trim, click on the part you want to keep, click what you want to trim it to. Click on the part you want to keep, trim it to here. Click on the part you want to keep, trim it to here. Okay. Vertical piece that's on the very end, and I'll say copy, and we have 630 for that tapered section. So I'm going to move this back minus 0.63. Where this horizontal line ends. So we go to home, wireframe, trim, this line to here, this line to here. Okay. We don't this one anymore, so I'll just click on it and delete. And 11 degrees. So if I draw a line, I'm going to click to the end here, stretch it out, and I look over here at the angle, it says 0. If I pull it down, it's 360, and it gets less and less and less. So if I put in here, maybe I'll put in here 0.3 and enter. And then here I'll put 360 minus 11. Obviously that's a little short, maybe I can lengthen it up a little bit more. There we go. So 0.7 is going to shoot it past the line, and then 349 is what our angle comes out to. Green check. And easy enough just to mirror this, so transform, mirror, this one, pops in right where we want it, so we're going to copy, make sure, and just check OK. Now when we want to put a little straight line here to make it proper at the very end, this line's bugging me a little bit. See how the stock is right here on that line? You want to move that stock off there a little bit so you can see it easier. We go back to our toolpath, stock setup, properties, right down here. You just put like 10 thousandths on the Z. See how this popped away a little? There, now I can see it easier. Wireframe trim. I'm going to trim this line to the angles on both sides, and then I'll come back and divide. I'll divide the center out. See how that leaves the little straight on the end there? And I can clean this up a little bit like that. Save. Okay. Now that's the easy part. So we're looking at, now we're going to have to look at the planes a little bit. We're looking at this on the DZ plane. But if I want to look from over here from the right, I'm going to try and see. Let's look at the right view here. Yeah, so we're looking in the opening of here on the right side. And great, I'll hit the equal sign with the right plane. So anything I draw, it comes out perpendicular or normal to how we're looking at it here. I'm going to draw a circle. See if I can just freehand it here. Click on the center. And out to right where that taper starts. Let's look here. What we got? Let's do the long lines first. It looks like the long lines are 540.